Assistant Professor in LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. This video is about subject Analog and Digital Communication System. So friends, we learn about the few digital communication concepts, that is the pulse code modulation, in the last video. Now, in this video, we are going to learn about the few technique again for use for the digital communication. So now, we are going to start with the important concepts which can be used in the CD or wherever the digital audio signals that has been recorded. So now, we are going to learn about the compounding. Now, this compounding word that is made up of the two different word, that is the compression which has been done at the transmitting end, and pounding mean the expanding. So expanding of the signal at the receiving end. So compression plus expanding, that is referred to as a compounding. Okay, so the compounding, okay, why it is used? Okay, so dilemma of the strong signals versus the weak signals, okay, which we have seen. Okay, so now what we need to do? So expansion and the compounding, okay, so compression and expansion, which is referred to as a compounding, and which is used at the transmitter, and the expansion will be used at the receiving end. Okay, so now we have seen the quantization process, and you know that, okay, here the quantization levels are there. So uniform means the step size is equal, and non-uniform means the step size is not equal. So in the non-uniform quantization, okay, process, after the transmitter uniformly quantizing the compressed signal, okay, at the receiver, the inverse process of the particular signal, that is known as the expansion of the signal, that is employed for avoiding the signal distortion. Okay, so the compression plus expansion, that is referred to as a compounding. So here in the diagram, which is, look at here, okay, so it is what? So you can see that our signal, that is the empty signal, okay, what we can do for our empty signal? My empty signal, let's suppose the analog signal, okay, so now this my empty signal, now to find out we need to discretize it, okay, so what we can do, we are discretizing by using the sampling and the quantization. So we have the quantized output, okay, so now after doing all these things, so this compression plus what is that, the expansion, okay, and that could be done at the transmitting end. Now this signal, which is transmitted via the channel, and it is received by the receiver. Now at the receiver, what should we do? We need to expand the signal, okay. So here you can see that the signal which is expanded and which is referred to as a M cap of T, okay. So for doing this, the compression and the expansion, the various laws that has been used, okay. So A law for the compounding. This A law for the compounding, it is used in the Europe. Okay. So now here you can see that this compression, this compounding law. Okay. Here you can see that the input signal, and here we are obtaining the output signal. Okay. Now we are applying the compounding technique. Okay. And we can see that at the value for the A is equal to 87.6. we have the maximum compounding, okay. So this is used in the Europe for the various television systems. For this, the equation for the y is a upon 1 plus log a m upon mp. Okay, where the value for the m by mp, that is between the 0 and the 1 by a. Okay, and again this value, okay, for the it is y is equal to y, that is the output, okay, and a, that is the value, okay, which we will get for the maximum compounding values, okay. So that is the, for the a it is the 87.6. okay, so y is equal to a upon 1 plus the log a, okay, in bracket the 1 plus log a into m upon mp. Okay, so this value, that is the m by mp value, while it is between the 1 by a and the 1. Another law for the compounding, that is the mu law. This mu law, that is again used in the North America. So in that broadcasting, all the communication system, they are using the system which is referred to as a mu law compounding. So this is the graph. Okay, this all are the reference graph. We should not draw, we should not derive this all the values, but we are referring this mu law compounding graph. Okay, so it is the input m by mp value and this is the output value. Okay, so you can see that the while the mu value, that is the 255, the maximum compounding output, okay, mean the compression and the expansion, so that our signal that we can receive at the receiving end without any distortion. Okay, so this is the equation. Again, we have to remember this equation. It is the y is equal to 1 upon log 1 plus mu, log 1 plus mu into m upon mp, for m by mp, that is between the 0 and 1. So this, the law, it is about the mu law and the a law. Okay, so now for the optimum S0 by NQ in the signal to quantization noise ratio in the America, okay, that is the mu is equal to 255 is used, so that the signal output, that is good, okay, and it, this ratio, okay, that is most desirable in all the systems. Okay, so here you can see that if mu is equal to 255, okay, we have the good output. Mu is equal to 0, again you can see that, and L value, that is the 256, mean the 8 bits we are representing for the each particular level. Okay, so the bandwidth that is required for this, okay, so in the binary TCM we have a group of n bits corresponding to L levels with n bits, and L is equal to 2 raised to n, or you can write the n is equal to log L base 2. So this way we can find it out, okay, what is the value of the n, what is the value of the L. So signal MT, that is the band limited to B hertz, okay, and which requires the twice B samples per second, okay. So for the twice and B elements of the information, we must transfer the twice and B bits per second. So minimum bandwidth that is required is how much? It is the twice and B bits per second. Okay, so it is the twice and B bits per second. And if practically speaking, usually we choose the transmission bandwidth to be a little higher than the minimum bandwidth that is the required. Okay, so if you have minimum bandwidth requirement, okay, higher than that, okay, then there is no problem of the collising or the loss of the information. So it is about the compounding which can be used, okay, in the communication. Now the next point, that is for the digital modulation technique, it is the differential pulse code modulation. It is a one step ahead than the DPCM. Now the problem with the PCM, that is the PCM is not really efficient because so many bits that taking a lots of bandwidths. Okay, so we know that there is a problem, okay, that is regarding the bandwidth. Okay, so you know that right now the problems, okay, that is about the bandwidth. We have a very less bandwidth and so many tasks we need to perform. Okay, so we should go for the technique, okay, we which can be used the less bandwidth. So can we improve on this? So our answer is yes. Yes, we can improve the bandwidth, okay? And how can we improve the bandwidth? So suppose we have a slowly varying the empty signal, okay? So now what we can do? That we can find out the difference between the two pulses, okay? You know that the sampled output you have. Now if the slowly varying signal mean the amplitude of that signal that varies the very slowly. So now in that kind of the signal, what we can do? We can take the one signal, we can take the one sample, we can take the another sample, okay? Now if we will find out the difference between the two samples, okay, two adjacent samples, okay, and if we will transmit that value of the sample, then what happened? That we can reduce the number of bits in the transmission of the technique. So the technique which will do all this task is referred to as a differential pulse code modulation, that is the DPCL, difference between the two adjacent samples. So suppose the MK be the kth sample reading of the empty signal, then we can express the difference between the two adjacent samples, that is the DK, and DK is equal to MK minus 1, okay? So the difference between the two adjacent samples, it is transmitted, so that is the DK value, okay? So what is the principle of the DPCM? That is, instead of transmission of the MK value, minus 1, the sampled value, we need to transmit what? That is the DK. And what we should do at the receiving end? At the receiving end, we are receiving the DK values, okay? And the previous value of the MK minus 1 that allows us to construct the MK value. So, difference of the successive samples, that is almost always is much smaller than the full range of the sample values, okay? So this benefit we will take in case of the DPCM, okay? And we can improve the efficiency of the PCM, okay, by requiring the fewer bits, okay? So we need to first of all use of the estimate of the MK value, okay? So now we are estimating the value and we will represent that estimate value, that is by MEST of K. So now the previous sample's value, that is suppose the MT, okay, and we are estimating the MEST value, then my DK value is what? It's a MK minus MEST of K, okay, and this DK value which is transmitted. At the receiving end, okay, we need to again determine the MEST value, okay, estimated value from the previous samples, okay, and we then generate the MK signals by adding the all the received DK signals. So this way we will recover the reconstruct the particular signal, okay. So now here the MT plus TS signal, okay, by using the Taylor series expansion, it is the MT plus TS d of MT by DT plus TS square, okay, plus the skew, you know the Taylor series. What we are doing? We are again neglecting the higher order component, and we have MT plus TS is equal to MT plus TS dMT by DT for the small TS, okay? So now the kth sample of the MT by MK, okay? So now we have the D by DT of the MK TS, that is what? So it is the MK TS minus M, KTS minus TS upon S, okay? So now we have the MK plus 1 value, it is equal to MK plus TS MK minus MK minus 1 TS, okay? So this way, what is the next sample value? MK plus 1, so it is the twice MK minus 1, okay? So we get the approximation value for the m cake for the k plus 1 samples, okay, from the two prior samples mk and the mk plus 1. Okay, so we can do even better this, okay, that is by writing the value, okay, like this, okay, and this all the values that are the predictor coefficients value for this, okay, and this will gives the values for the previous sample. Now the block diagram of the DPCM transmitter, what is it? It is, we have the empty signal, okay, we have the another value, that is the estimated value. By taking the input value and the estimated value, we have the decay value and that quantized value we are transmitting. Again, that value we are taking as a reference, okay, and we have the value. So decay is mk minus m estimate of the k, okay, and dqk is the dk plus qk, where qk is the quantization error, okay, and this predicted output that is fed back to the input to the predictor mqk, and which is given by mqk is equal to mqk plus dqk, and it is equal to mk minus dk plus dqk is equal to mk plus qk, okay, where mqk is the quantized version of the mk. At the receiving end, we are receiving the DQK samples and we need to compare it with the estimated value. Okay, so you can see over here that the predicted output that gives us the MSK, okay, and difference between that gives us the value of the output, okay. So here you can see that the MQK is equal to what? The MK plus QK, and we can receive the signal and we have the output, okay, that output, that is what, that's our the received signal. So it is about the DPCM compounding, okay. So next version of the DPCM, that is the ADPCM, okay, delta modulation. So we will see in the next video. So thank you very much. I will